New in IronCAD 2018 is the alternate view positioning capability in the drawing. In order to use this, you need a mechanism in the 3D. In this model is a mechanism model. We've actually created three configuration states, which is this is the default state, state 2, and then we have a state 3. And we did this within the mechanism mode. We basically turned on our mechanism mode, moved our parts in each various configuration, and then save that mechanism mode under the configuration. So you simply just create three configurations that store position in it for your assemblies and your parts. You create those configurations, use the mechanism mode, save that state in that particular configuration, and you're all set to call these out on the drawing. So we can now go into our drawing. We'll just create a new drawing, say a C size. And we'll just create a view. Now, the alternate view positioning can be used on any view. In this case, it works best for this front view in this model. But simply right-click on the model, go to alternate position view, and you'll see you have what the base configuration is, which is our state 1, or you can change it to a different state if you want something to be the different one. In our case, we want state 1, which is this current position, as our base configuration. And then we can add alternate views to overlay on this model. So we're going to add state 2, and then we can add state 3. To this. In each one of these, you can set various settings. For example, we want maybe a dot lines instead of dash. We can also set up default colors for these. For example, maybe the state 3, we want a purple so we can see that state 3. For state 2, we want to have a dot for that one, and we want a different color, maybe a gray color. So you can see this is state 3. This is state 2 inside of here. You can also set up different styles for this in your standard styles and layers. You can set up default settings for your alternate position view as well if you like to set those up by default. Just hit OK, and this will create your views with those positions. Notice this is our state 2, and this is our state 3. The base configuration is the top one, so if anything is at the same state, for example, like all these parts here, all they don't move, the base configuration is drawn on top so you don't see all the other dotted lines. But then your other moving parts will get drawn based on the styles and layers that you defined. You can also dimension between these. So if we go into our dimension tool, for example, maybe we want to have a dimension between how far these travel on these two objects. We can click that, hit tab to position that movement there. Let's unlock that dimension, place that there. We can also do another one. Maybe we want to do a height dimension from the overall travel of this. We can say how far did this travel from the height on this object in here. And notice you'll see a few cursor movements because it is actually toggling between all three configurations to make sure that you're hitting on the right object when you place these. So you can see this various dimension capabilities are available to you. We can click off that to see our values and our alternate view positions. Hope you enjoy.